Welcome to Lucas's Philippines.
Hi everyone. Going on a walk to go and hopefully buy some dragon fruit and maybe a papaya. I seen some people earlier on the side of the road when I was coming home from the gym this morning that had some for sale. These guys are either doing PE class or cheer practice or something. The school has their PE class here on occasion. So you're not just sitting here in silence, watching the world go by. One of my friends mentioned it might be a good idea to make a video about some useful Tagalog phrases. I can't guarantee my pronunciation is that great, but you know, that gives people who know the opportunity to laugh at me, which is fine. I laugh at me too. Some of the more useful ones, if you're going to buy something, for example, at a sorry store, right there, at the sorry store, in case you don't remember, these little neighborhood stores that have a window like that. They don't always speak English, or even understand English. Sometimes they do. In a regular grocery store, they usually understand English, because I think that's part of the work requirements, the job requirement, is that they do speak English, even though sometimes they don't. But anyways, if you're going to one of those stores, and you want to know if they have something, I don't know, like, say you want some San Miguel Light, right? Well, you can just say San Mig Light, and they know that. You get real fancy and say cervezas, but most of the time people just say beer. But back to the point. If you want to say, do you have San Mig Light? You would say, meron kayong ng San Mig Light. Is a guayabano tree, also known as soursop. Again, the phrase for do you have is meron, which means have, kayo, like you. Like, if you're asking the store, do you have, you're not asking the person, but you're asking the store, and the person is their store representative. So, meron kayo ng whatever it is you're looking for. You can also add that NG, that's what makes that nong sound. It makes another sound in other words, but I can't make that sound. I suck at it. But you can add that onto the kayo, so mero kayong, and then whatever you're asking for. Also, say for example, you want to know where the mall is. Well, most malls here, SM, or Robinson's, usually. Those are the major ones. There's others, but anyways, to get the point, if you want to know where it is, and the person you're asking doesn't know what you're asking, You can say saan. Saan. That's S-A-A-N. I'll put subtitles. Saan ang S-M. Ang A-N-G. That's kind of like a the. So where's the S-M? I'm not very good at grammar. But yeah, that's another useful phrase. On where? So even if you can't remember on or any of that, on, they'll understand you're saying where. Where and then whatever it is you're trying to find. I've covered useful Jeep phrases in other videos where I ride a Jeep. Trying to think. Oh yeah. I'm going to buy something, also when you go to the store, and you want to know how much something is, that word would be makano. How much? Makano. And if you're buying more than one thing and you want to know how much everything is, that'd be makano lahat. Lahat is everything, or all. So how much is all of it? People are fucking staring at me because I'm talking to myself. Whatever. And those people that were selling dragon fruit are gone. Damn it. That's alright. I think they have some of the palenque. Maybe. I'm also going to the lottery. And my arm is getting tired again. Yeah, they were right over there on the side of the road. For sale! I'm not buying that though. Numbers. That might be useful to know. There are Tagalog numbers, you know, Isa, Dalawa, Tatlo. But people here, I hardly ever hear them use actual Tagalog numbers most of the time. It's either like Spanish numbers when they're telling the time, telling you what time it is. Or there's a news show, 24 horas, says 24 hours, in case you don't know Spanish either. But like, when you're talking to people and numbers are involved, most of the time, I say like 90% of the time, it's English numbers. And I ain't walking out there because somebody will run me over. Last time I walked down here to the lottery, I walked through this area right up here. You might have noticed there's a bunch of sinks, kitchen sinks, bathroom sinks, toilets. I think there might even be some shower heads and faucets and things in there, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, you can buy stuff like that down there. There's another example of Spanish, vaquiador. They sharpen their knives, see? Knives, scissors. They even sharpen electric trimmers, nail clippers, everything. They sell them there too. can't really think of any other useful phrases. I mean, you can pretty well get by on English most of the time. There's a few times, you know. Rice. If for some reason you run into a person that doesn't know the word rice in English, uncooked rice is bigas. Regular, already cooked rice, tanin, or tanin, my pronunciation sucks. My grammar's even worse. Some army guys. Yay. So, yeah, here's the lottery again. I'll come back when I'm walking up to the palenque. I'm gonna walk around the back way just for fun. Alright, so when I was walking away from the lotto, there was a guy selling me dessert bread. So I guess there's some other things that are kind of useful to know. If you don't know what somebody said and you want to say what, and they don't understand what, for whatever reason, the word for what is ano, A-N-O, ano. You know, get that intonation in there, otherwise you sound like a robot. Yeah, but anyways, yeah, he wanted to sell me a dessert bread called pastillas. I didn't want them. If you don't want something that somebody's selling, you tell them ayoko. Ayoko means I don't like it, or I don't want it. You know the market area back here. You can also just say no. Hindi, which the more correct term, at least according to my wife, is ayoko. I don't want it. And they'll leave you alone. Usually. Not always, but usually. You also have the option to just keep walking. If you ignore them, they'll go away. They might think you're a dick, but they'll leave you alone. To say that. Get back to that ano statement. And that's just what, but you know, what's that? Ano yan. Yan, I guess it's spelled Y-A-N. It's like, ano yan, what's that? Or, ano ito, what is it? And if it's a bread, this the regular word for bread is tinapay. That's a bread. For some reason, somebody is selling sandwiches, which I haven't seen. But if they are, if I remember correctly, the word for sandwich is palaman. But that's about really all the useful phrases I can think of. Let's see if I can find the dragon fruit. mostly vegetables in here. And the word for vegetables is gulai. Gulai. That's vegetables. Fruit. It's pretty close to the English word for fruit. It's fruit. Or frutas. This guy has. I usually buy fruit from this guy because he has most everything. I think that's honey over there in that corner. I don't see any. Is there any down here? Nope. I'm out the other direction. That's a big ass papaya. It's huge! Sometimes there's a fruit vendor out here in the front. Sometimes. And they got rambutan. Those are kind of good. I want the red ones, preferably not the turning black ones. Do you know where they have dragon fruit at? Kano rambutan.
75 1 kilo, sir.
Maybe. Some kind of what kind of beat up. But flies are attracted to the smell. Kind of a pomelo. 100 a kilo? How much does one weigh? How much does it weigh?
123.
All right. I'll get that. And then how much are the bananas?
65 kilo.
How much is this one?
160.
Okay. So I got a pomelo and some bananas. If you're wondering what a pomelo is, A pomelo is kind of like a grapefruit. Pretty close. Because they're not usually as sour as a grapefruit. They're a little bit sour, but you're not gonna suck in your own face because it's so sour. Anyways, that's my adventure for today. Hope some of the phrases I came up with was helpful. If you can think of any other ones, any other phrases you might use, go ahead and put them in the comment, and I'll try and see what I can do about getting you an accurate translation and not a Google translation. Oh yeah, in case you forgot or didn't know, I do have a Patreon now. No pressure. Just kidding. And I'll put that link in the description below. If Patreon isn't your thing, and you want to just use PayPal, because Patreon is a monthly recurring payment thing. Some people don't like that. But for PayPal, all you need is my email, and I'll put my email in the description. Even though there is a Google button on my channel page, but you know. Anyways, I'll just put the email in the description also. Can't really think of anything else. So, like I said, if you can think of some other phrases that you'd want to know how to say, just put it in the comments and I'll try to get you an accurate translation, not a Google translation, not a English to Tagalog translation, because you know those don't work out so well either. I can just ask my wife if I don't know, and yeah, so that's how that works out. Once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.